G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. I just thought I'd show you this update I'm doing on this 250/9 German Halftrack. I'm just going to practice a whitewash on this just before I do my German Panzer 3. So I thought I'd just show you a bit of a preview of what this kit looks like beforehand. All in all, I'd say this is a pretty nice kit. Probably the only two things that obviously, I mean, it was done in the 1980s, so it was a long time ago, but even today it's a nice kit to build up. A little bit lacking in parts, but you know, that's what you expect from the 1980s, and also some of the moulding or the fine detail on some of the bolts and stuff like that isn't as fine as what it is today. Well, I really enjoy building this kit. It's very fast, it's a weekend build, and I'll just take you through the instructions quickly before I show you the actual build-up. So here's the first page of the instructions. And what I always like about Tamiya kits is they normally give you a figure in the kit, and I'd like Dragon to start doing that. It's always nice to get a tank, but it's also nice if you actually get one or two figures to put in it so you can actually show the scale of the actual vehicle you're building. Also, what I like about Tamiya is they always give you a bit of a rundown of the actual kit and the actual tank itself in real life or half track. I think that's also a nice touch. Pretty basic kit to build. Starts off with the wheels and the main part of the hull there. Goes together very quickly. Even the tracks here, which really amazes me, back in the 1980s, that Tamiya actually had these little link tracks. I don't know why they don't do them now. I know they're starting to do some of the linking stuff on the newer kits, but it's been a long time in between. I didn't mind putting these together. They weren't too complicated. I actually ended up gluing my tracks to the actual wheels themselves so I could pull the whole set off here, off altogether, for painting. The other thing that amazed me about this kit is the actual wheels do turn, they steer, which I'll show you on the actual kit, which I think even on some of Tamiya's kits today they don't do, so it actually quite surprised me that these wheels turned. Just a build up of where the seats are for the driver, and I believe maybe the radio operator as well. Again, and the thing I love about these Tamiya kits is just that the instructions are just so simple, so easy and so quick. If you really want to just grab a kit, if you're on holidays or something like that, you can go away for a weekend and build one of these up. And then when you've got time, you can paint it up. But I'd say you can pretty much knock over this build easy in a day or two, if you're really keen. Just flipping over to the other side. Actually, I did change my barrel there. I just changed it for an aftermarket barrel. I'll just cut that off and changed it over. I'll probably end up putting a bit of a tarp over the top of it or something like that, because it's, as I'm going to be putting in a bit of a winter scene with a bit of whitewash over the top, as I've said before. I've got a nice figure here. Very much almost looks like an Alpine miniatures figure in the stance with the binoculars, only that it's about in the 1980s, and compared to an Alpine miniatures figure today, this figure just won't hold up. Very old figure. If you're actually going to put a lot of time and effort into building this kit, I'd say, and thinking about putting it in a contest, I'd definitely be saying changing the figure. But if you're just someone new to the hobby, I'd say give this figure a paint. Try and paint it up as well as you can, and that'll help you paint your next figure up. These figures are great to paint up if you're just learning how to paint. Don't go and buy a resin figure or something worth $20 or so if you're just learning how to paint. Go through a lot of these old Tamiya kits, pull out the figures or Dragon kits and try and paint these up first. Once your skills get up to a decent level, then I'd say spend the money and buy a resin figure. Again, I really like how Tamiya give you a separate page on the painting. They also give you a bit of information about the painting colours at the time of the war. I really like this colour here. I probably would have done that if I was building this kit again today, but I actually built this kit quite some time ago. And as I've said, I'm just trying to practice a whitewash over the top of it, so my camo colours aren't actually any of these colours on this page at all. I've just did them up a long time ago, and I'll give you a quick look at it. Here we have it here, guys. As I said before, I can't remember exactly, but I think I probably painted this kit. It must be close to 10 years ago now. I actually just used Tamiya spray cans on this half track, and I actually wasn't very happy with the outcome of the spray cans at the time, not because of the cans themselves, but because I actually just sprayed the paint on too many layers, which then caused it to be a little bit too thick. So what I end up having to do is go around and sand with a light sandpaper just around the edges of the yellow areas, because I actually end up blue tacking that, and then I sprayed the green over the top, and then I pulled the blue tack off, and because I'd done so many layers of the green, it just didn't turn out as well as I liked it. So I basically put it in the cupboard for about 10 years or less, a little bit less, and I wasn't very happy with it. But then I decided I was going to do a whitewash on my Panzer 3 that I'm doing now, if you want to check out some of the videos on that. And I thought I'd give this a practice run. So I pulled this back out again, and then I actually quite enjoyed just the look of this vehicle. So then I started weathering it up a little bit, and I thought I'd end up probably giving this a whitewash, and then I'll obviously weather it up a little bit more. There's a couple of little things that I need to fix up on the paint, but yeah, I just really enjoyed this kit. I enjoyed building it at the time. I remember it, how easy it went together, so much so that I went out and bought another one. These are very cheap kits to buy. I think I might have picked this up maybe for about 25 Australian dollars at the time, and I think you can pick it up now for almost around 30. So if you're just a beginner, I'd say this is an absolute crack of a kit to start off with. I've sort of put a couple of layers of dull coat on it now. I'm not too worried about how it turns out, because as I said, I wasn't too happy with the camo colour and design that I picked that length of time ago. So this is just going to be a practice run. I wouldn't say I'm totally unhappy with it, but I just think I probably could do better today. So I'll probably end up putting maybe an Alpine miniatures figure or two in it, and just putting it on just a standalone base. I don't think I'll bother putting in a diorama or anything like that. Can really recommend this kit. There's nothing really wrong with this kit. Obviously, you know, it's an early kit from the 1980s, but you know, compared to some kits today, I built a Lee kit a long time ago, LEE kit of a BMP, or might have been a T-55, and it was absolutely a shock of a kit to put together. So even though it's an old kit, it does rate highly compared to some other kits out there today, or some of the older kits. Anyway, guys, I thought I'd just give you a quick look at that before I put a whitewash on it, and then I hopefully should put another video up of it once it's been whitewashed.